Hi, welcome to the Erbology channel. Today's guide is for cordyceps mushroom. First up, I should mention that there are a couple of different types of cordyceps. The kind we make is called Cordyceps sinensis, which is also known as caterpillar fungus. Why? Well, in the wild, this special fungus has a fascinating life cycle. In the highlands of Tibet, Nepal and China, the spores infect moth larvae in the soil. Eventually, the fungus emerges out of the top of the caterpillar's head. Foragers go looking for the little stalk of the fungus and collect it together with a caterpillar to be sold sometimes for thousands of dollars a kilo. Unfortunately, this can lead to over-harvesting, which is damaging to the environment and local economy. Plus, we prefer our cordyceps without the sight of moth caterpillar. That's why at Erbology we grow our cordyceps mushroom in a controlled environment. That means the mushroom gets all of the nutrients it needs with no need to chow down on a moth caterpillar. So why is cordyceps so good for you? Adherents of traditional Chinese medicine have been using cordyceps for thousands of years to nourish both yin and yang. And there's plenty of scientific interest in the modern day too. Scientists have identified two health-supporting compounds in cordyceps, beta-glucans and cordycepin. Beta-glucans are special polysaccharides found in some fungi, which are thought to have lots of health-promoting effects. Cordycepin is an active compound thought to regulate the immune system. Our cordyceps has over 47% of beta-glucans and can reach up to 8 mg of cordycepin per 1 gram of cordyceps. That's extremely high. Cordyceps is naturally full of antioxidants, which help protect the body from damage by free radicals. This is an area of interest for scientists looking into treatment for dementia and may also be of use in anti-aging. It also appears to have anti-inflammatory properties. It's important to say that the studies looking into this have only been done on mice, and we don't have enough information yet to say how cordyceps might work in human disease. However, cordyceps is best known for being an invigorating tonic. It's traditionally thought to help boost your energy, support your athletic performance, and even boost your sex drive. One study indicated that cordyceps could reduce fatigue in mice, while another showed that athletes were better able to clear lactic acid from their muscles after taking cordyceps. So if you're keen to give cordyceps a try, what's the best way to take it? Well, unlike some medicinal mushrooms, cordyceps has quite a neutral mushroomy taste, so it's easy to add into soups and stews. Alternatively, I like to mix half a teaspoon of our powder into coffee or hot chocolate in the morning. I take it for about 2 to 3 months, after which I let my body rest. That's a lowdown on cordyceps. As always, you can find the studies I've cited in the description box below or go to herbology.co for more.